Hi everyone, in this video I'll be explaining you about commit and rollback in MySQL. So let's get started. So first let me create that database and table. So let me just now run it. So what commit statement does is that whenever we use a commit statement, it just saves our database, alright, the tables and the values that we inserted, it just saves our database. And once we have given the commit statement, we cannot undo any of our changes. So rollback is basically used to undo those changes. So in MySQL workbench, first thing what you need to do is, so in MySQL workbench, in order to know about the working of commit and rollback, the first thing what you need to do is you need to go to query option over here and you need to like uncheck the auto commit transaction. So by default it will be like this, I guess. Yeah, it will be checked, and if you just click it, that option will be unchecked. So if you aren't doing this, automatically all your queries will be committed. Like you can't roll back anything, you can't undo anything. So we won't be able to see the function of rollback over there. So you have to like uncheck this particular thing, auto commit transactions. So once you have done that, let me just now insert some values. I just created a table. Let me just insert the first value and let me just now insert the second value. So this thing is not now committed, okay? This is like just, I'm just inserting the value and this is now not saved anywhere. Like it will be there in the table, it will be there in the database, but it is not saved, okay? But it's unsaved one and it still can be rolled back. So if I just now go to my table, so here you can see I'm having the both the values, but it is not saved. So for saving it now, I will put commit, that's it, commit keyword and a semicolon. If I just now run it, so we will be getting a green mark over here. So which means that these values, okay, these values are saved forever. Okay, the only, like, we cannot roll back the changes. We can delete these changes. Obviously, we can use the delete command and delete this. But we cannot undo or roll back these particular values. Okay, so now let me show you the use of rollback. So now we have committed two rows, okay, these values. So now let me clear the console. And let me just now insert another one. Okay, I will go with 3 and 300. I will run it. And let me go with 4 and 400. Run this as well. So now the fact is that if I go to my student table, we inserted the first two rows and we committed it. So first two rows are now saved and cannot be undone. After inserting the third and fourth row, we didn't commit anything. We didn't use the commit statements, which means that the insertion of this three and fourth row can be rolled back or undone. So if I just now use the rollback statement, basically what will happen is that our third and fourth row will be gone. Because that will be like rollbacked. Like rollback means like it will be reverted to the original state how it was earlier. And the first two rows won't go because after inserting the first two rows, we use the commit statement. So basically third and fourth row will disappear now. So if I just clear the console and if I just now go and type rollback and if I just run it. So as I told you, third and fourth row will go. So if I just go to select asterisk from student. So here you can see third and fourth row has gone. So this is basically the use of commit statement just for saving all your work. And once you use the commit statement, you cannot like redo it. And rollback is used to redo all the changes that you have done after a commit, basically. Okay. So this is how you do it. And I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also run many other tutorials in MySQL, MongoDB, Node.js, React.js, C, C++, Java, Python. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.